Hello, 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 hello. I'm not going to be long. I'm going to get started in about 30 more seconds. Blessings to you, blessings to you. Let me turn my music down.
Sometimes we worship.
Okay. My name is Apostle Elisa Biggers, and I would like to welcome you to this week's Deliver Me Nugget. All I need is a couple minutes of your time. Blessings, blessings, blessings to you. I dare, blessings, how you doing, Elder? I dare not take it for granted that you're here with me on this broadcast. I won't be with you long because I'm in the midst of construction, amen. But today we're going to talk about tips to recognize that you need deliverance. Tips to recognize that you need deliverance. Can I tell you, a lot of times people need deliverance, but they don't even know that they need deliverance. A lot of times people just go to church and they think, so I go to church that I'm good, not understanding that we've been in this world system all our lives, and a lot of times we don't know what we're doing wrong. We don't know what we're hindering ourselves. We're messing up ourselves, and we don't even know. And so this is why I'm an advocate for deliverance. Blessings to you, woman of God, for deliverance and inner healing. The Bible say in Luke 4 and 18 that Jesus came to set the captive free. He came to set free those that are oppressed. A lot of times people don't know that they are oppressed. What is deliverance? Deliverance where you have been bound by darkness. You've been blind by a particular situation. It's where we're exposing and we're revealing toxic mindsets, bad attitudes, where you've been in captivity in your thought process, where you've been in danger based on situations and circumstances. Well, a lot of times, because we've been molested, we've been hurt, we've been raped, we've been rejected, we've been depressed, all these things have caused us to be bound. What do I mean bound? Bound in your mind, bound in your thinking. And people are walking around thinking that they're free when they're really in bondage. People are walking around paranoid, not understanding that they're in the trap of the enemy. And so the first thing that is to know that you need deliverance, when you think nothing is wrong with you, when you say, oh, I'm fine, there's nothing wrong with me, I don't have any demons, I don't have any unclean spirits, that's an indication you need deliverance. Because as long as you here on earth, guess what that means? That you need deliverance. Heck, I need deliverance. I got issues that I'm working through myself. And so as long as you're here on this earth, there's going to be some things that you're going to have to deal with. Because we went through a lot of different situations in our upbringing, as well as an adult. Guess what? If you don't deal with unresolved issues, they're going to follow you to your adult life. And a lot of times people being mistreated, they bitter, they anger, they frustrated, they disappointed. And guess what it does? It caused those demons to begin to set in your mindset, and it begins to cause you to look at things in a dysfunctional manner. And so when you can't see that you need deliverance, when you can't see that nothing is wrong with you, that's an indication that you need deliverance. Number two, another tip that you need deliverance: when you are unteachable, when nobody can't teach you nothing, when you act as if you know everything, you want to, every time somebody try to talk to you, you get offended. Whenever you correct it and people trying to tell you the truth about you and they trying to help you, but you don't recognize that it's the truth, you looking at it from the lenses of offense, you need deliverance. Because you got to understand, we all need help. We need somebody to help us, because guess what? Iron sharpens iron. Are you your brother's keeper? Are you your sister's keeper? Because there's some things you may not see about yourself that somebody else can see that can help you. But if nobody can't tell you anything about yourself, that's an indication you're dealing with a spirit of pride. You're dealing with a spirit of self-righteousness. You're dealing with a spirit of insecurity. And guess what? We need each other. I don't care if you're an apostle, prophet, teacher, whoever. There are always things that we need to improve on. And so when nobody can't tell you anything, and when you don't want to hear the truth about you, that's an indication you need deliverance. Because if nobody can't tell you that something need to be corrected, and that's letting you know you got a problem with authority. When there's no change in your life, you're doing the same thing, you're repeating the same cycles, you're not learning, you keep going into the same mistake, that's an indication you need deliverance. Everybody else around you, they growing. They're maturing. They seeing when they need to do better. They working on when they need to do better. But you think everything is fine with you? You finding fault with everybody else? That's an indication you're dealing with pride. And what you're doing is you're trying to project your feelings on other people because you don't want to deal with you. And see, and this is what's going on with us a lot of times in the church, and especially us in the body of Christ. We saying that we love God, we saying that we represent Him, but we are bound by unclean spirits. We got attitudes, we'll cuss you out, we'll lie to you, we'll mistreat you, we have no character, we have no integrity, we don't care how we treat one another, we don't care how we talk to one another. These are indications that you need deliverance, that you need the Spirit of God to come in and to show you those areas of darkness in your life. So when you can't see areas of darkness in your life, that's an indication you are bound by a demonic spirit. When you don't have any consistency, you up and down, like you going up a hill, up and down, that's an indication that you need deliverance. We're supposed to always be at a place that we're always growing, and it should be a place of consistency. But if you're not consistent, that's an indication that you need deliverance. When you always going around circles, you're not learning from your mistakes. You make a mistake and you go back and do the same thing because you never learned from it. You never sat back and see, why didn't that relationship work? You go jump into another relationship and you do the same thing in that relationship into your new relationship because you never took the time to see what was wrong with you. And this is what's wrong. We always feel like we got to be around somebody. We want to keep ourselves busy when we don't want to deal with ourselves. We got to understand that's a spirit that you're dealing with. It's poor self-esteem, self-hatred. When you don't want to deal with you, when you want to find fault with other people, when you can't look in the mirror at yourself, you can't find the error in yourself, because guess what? Our human nature, our fleshly nature is sinful. So when you can't see that something is wrong with you, that's an indication that you need deliverance. When you don't hear God's voice, I don't hear God talking to me, I don't know what God's saying to me, that's an indication you got so many voices going on in your mind, you don't know God's voice. That's an indication that you're in trouble, because the only voice you hear of what you hear on television, what you hear with people talking to you, but you don't hear what the Father is saying to you. Why is this important? Because He, Holy Spirit, lives on the inside of you. So if He lives on the inside of you and you don't hear Him talking to you, that's not good. That's an indication you have sealed Him off from your life and you have become your own God. In other words, so you're doing whatever you feel like and you're not listening to the voice of your Father. This is an indication that you need deliverance. When you can't pray, I don't know what to say, I don't know the word, you can't read the Bible, you don't remember what you read. These are indications that you're bound by unclean spirits. Unclean spirits are operating within you, and you don't hear what God is saying. You're trying to read the Word of God, and you don't forget what you read, or you read, and you say, I just can't focus. I just can't get this. This don't make sense to me. That's an indication that you are bound by demonic spirits. And see, a lot of times, and you may say, oh, that's me with a lot of this stuff. And this is why we don't see signs, wonders, and miracles in our churches. Blessings, Pastor, because we got a lot of stuff going on, and the Spirit of God is saying we need deliverance, and we're going to churches that's not letting us know that we need deliverance. People are telling us that we're fine as long as you show up. Can I tell you, that's a trick of the enemy? As long as you show up and you think that you're fine, you got to do more than just show up. You got to do more than just say, I know the scripture. No, you got to become the scripture. You got to become the word. You got to let the word convict you. You got to let the word deal with your heart. You got to let the word tell you when you got unforgiveness in your heart. You got to allow the Spirit of God to deal with you. When you holding people hostage, you're remembering what they did to you. It's been 10 years and you remember what they did to you like it was yesterday. You still hurt. You still talking about the pain. This is the indication that you need deliverance. Blessings, Pastor. This is the indication that you are suffering. When you are always talking about the past, you always talking about what they did to you, how they made made you feel. Those people are gone on about their business, but you still bound by what they did. You need deliverance. God didn't mean for you to be stuck. He didn't mean for you to be at this place. He meant for you to go forward. That's why he said, cast your cares upon me because I care for you. See, that's right, woman of God, bondage. And see, and that's why I say we need deliverance, because we walking around with all this bondage. We walking around with 10 people on our heart, 15 people on our mind. Some people can't go to sleep because they upset about what these people did, because they choose not, they don't want to forgive. They don't want to let it go. See, we got to understand we're operating in sin because the Bible says he forgave us. So we got to begin to forgive those who have hurt us. And because why do we forgive them? We forgive them for us, not for them, but for you. Because Jesus said, I forgave you. So guess what? You got to forgive other people. And saying this is what we got to begin to learn and stop playing church. And you got to become the church. It's time for us to walk in deliverance. We got to get in the word of God. It's time out to keep on calling the pastor because something is wrong with you when you don't know the word to pray for yourself. They stalk you. So yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. That is so true. And this is why we got to stop. We got to know the word for ourselves. Because when you stand before Jesus, he's not going to ask you about that pastor. He's not going to ask you about that apostle. He's going to ask you about you. This is why a lot of times people don't know what to pray. You pray the word. And a lot of times people don't know the word because they're not spending time in the studying. They're not spending time learning the word. You got to learn the word. The Bible says he's coming back for his word. He ain't coming back for our crying, tears, and snotty nose. He wants us to begin to call, to manifest his word. The Bible said that we are sons of the Most High God. We got to begin. That's right. And he's not taking any excuses. This is why you see a lot of folks dying. You see a lot of these people dying because they thinking that, you know what, we're exempt. We're not exempt. We got to understand the Bible say judgment starts with the church first. You are the church because we're supposed to know better. But guess what? The Bible said my people perish because they lack knowledge, because they're not putting themselves in a place where somebody would teach them. See, a lot of times people say, oh, I don't want to hear what she's talking about. I don't want to hear, because a lot of times we don't want to deal with our issues. I understand that, because I used to be like that. I didn't want to hear about my issues. I want to focus on everybody else's issues. But that was a place of denial. That was a place where I didn't want to own up to what I was doing was wrong. Well, I didn't want to change, but I'm telling you, you can't expect all these blessings if you're not delivered. Why? Because why would God give $1 million to a person who's not delivered? You know why? Because you'll turn around and hurt them. You'll turn around and mistreat other people. See, that's why I believe one of the reasons why Joseph had to go through what he had to go through. So when it was his time to forgive his brothers, he did not mistreat them because he remembered what God did for him. And see, and this is where we got to begin to be at a place where we can't forget about what God did for you. If God didn't punish you, if he gave you another opportunity, you got to forgive people and you got to let God deal with those people. A lot of times we want people to hurt because we're hurting. And see, and this is where we got to own up to God and say, hey, I'm hurting. I need you to take this pain out of my heart. I need you to take this unforgiveness out of my heart. I need you to, this person that I'm always remembering. If you wake up in the morning thinking about that person, all throughout the day you thinking about that person, you are holding that person hostage. When you're so angry and you say, God, I hope they die. I hope they lose their car. I hope they lose their mind. What you're doing, you're bitter, you're resentment, and you're harsh, and you're evil. And see, a lot of times we think that we got to murder somebody to be evil. No, we don't. When we're harboring these things in our hearts and we're not trying to get it out, this is why so many people got kidney failure. This is why so many people got a lot of ailments, because a lot of the ailments, it isn't because of anything they did in the physical. It's because they're things that they're holding hostage. Holding people hostage in the spiritual realm. And see, and this is why you got to pay attention when you can't pray, when you can't read your Bible, when you're seeing everybody else's issues but your own. That's a spirit of pride. We got to begin to own up and say, yep, that's me. Lord, forgive me. I've been prideful. Lord, help me to take my eyes off of them and to put my eyes on you. The Bible began to say in Colossians, set your mind on the things up above and not on what you see. A lot of times we're so nosy in other people's business when we need to be focusing on our own business. This is why a lot of times we're bound. People got out the riders and they got all this stuff going on because some of those things are demonic spirit lodged in your body. Because see, if we don't understand the spiritual realm, a demon needs a body in order for it to display itself. So when you find yourself being sickly, when you find yourself with infirmity, disease, demons sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes demons will lodge in your body and you will begin to ache and pain because a demonic spirit is there and because you did not deal with your issue. And this is why we got to spend time. I'm telling you about me. This is why when I had a lot of self-hatred, I had to begin to tell God, I don't like myself. You know, I don't like my nose. I don't like these marks on my face. I had to begin to ask him to heal me. I had to own up. Do you know it made me feel some kind of way? But I understood if I wanted to be delivered, I had to come clean. And I had to begin to say, Lord, I need help. And see, a lot of times when you don't want to say that you need help, you need deliverance. When you don't want to ask for help, you need deliverance. When you don't want to talk about your issue, you need deliverance. And this is why we got to stop playing church. Stop thinking because you hear in every prophecy, they telling you about your house and your car, but you bound with demonic spirits. You got some people can't sleep at night. They tossing to and fro because they dealing with tormenting spirits that they're not dealing with their issue. You got to understand Holy Spirit lives on the inside of you. And so he talks to us by what's going on in our body. He'll begin to show you something going on with your leg and you know ain't nothing wrong. He's letting you know something is wrong. Something don't came in. And you got to understand, this is why we stay in a place of prayer and fasting and we saying, God, help me. I need you to wash me. I need you to cleanse me. I need you to deliver me. That's right, Karina. I need you to help me to let this go. It don't feel good, but help me to let them go. Help me to stop rehearsing the past. See, stop talking about the past. We got to stop being around these people. They want to talk about what happened 15 years ago. They want to keep on talking about it. And you got some people, they don't want to move forward. They want to keep on talking about it over and over. They did this. They did that. And every time y'all change subject, they bring it right back. See, that's an indication of a person that don't want to move on. That person needs deliverance. And see, a lot of times you wonder why you can't go forward. Because if every time you and that person always talking about it in the past, that's an indication right there. That's a toxic relationship. That's his toxic behavior. And we got to begin to understand when you're around toxic people. Yeah, you may love people, but when you make up your mind that you want to get right and you want to get healed, you'll begin to find out people will turn on you. The moment that I decide that I want to be healed, people begin to turn on me. Why you want to act like you better than everybody else? Why you want to get into that church stuff? Why you want to do all this praying? Why you want to go to church? Because see, they like me better miserable. They like me better when I was angry. They like me better when I was evil, talking negative just like them. But the moment that I made up my mind, I don't want to be like this. I'm tired of harboring people in my heart. Everybody else flourishing, but I'm still talking about the past. No, that's an indication that you gonna always be right there until you make up your mind to let that thing go. And you got to begin to ask God, grace me to go through this. Grace me to let this go. I need you to help me. And see, and that's the problem. We're not asking Holy Spirit for help. We say, I need you to help me. Help me because I can't do this by myself. He promised us that he would never leave us, nor would he forsake us. But you got to be willing to do your part. You got to be willing to be connected with him, talking to him, depending on him, leaning on him, saying, God, I trust you. I trust you to help me. I trust you to bring me through. But if you don't want to do that, guess what? You're going to be bound. You're going to be bound by darkness. You're going to be bound in your mind. This is why some people can't focus. This is why you can't see yourself going back to school. You can't see yourself doing any better because you need deliverance. Your mind is cluttered with darkness. You got darkness going on in your mind and you are oppressed. You don't want to go back to school. You don't want to lose weight. You don't want to change your habits. You don't want to go back to school. You don't want to educate yourself. You need deliverance. You need deliverance. Don't get offended with me. Please, I'm trying to help you, because see, sometimes I have found out people will say they love you, but they'll watch you be in bondage. They'll watch you be in darkness, and they will not open up their mouths. But see, I'm trying to help you. I hope I provoke you to say, you know what? I got to examine myself. You got to understand, if you're going to be delivered, you got to really examine yourself and say, I need some help. You got to really examine yourself, and you got to get with somebody who's going to really help you. You got to get with somebody who's going to, I call it a voice of truth. Get with somebody who's going to tell you the truth about you. Because sometimes we can be around people that won't tell you the truth about you. Oh, you my friend. Oh, you can't handle it. No, yes, I can handle it. Because if you love me, you're going to be willing to tell me the truth about me. You're going to be willing to help me. Some people won't help you. They'll watch you drown. They'll watch you go through. And they won't lift up a finger, but they saying that they love you. No, we need deliverance. We need to be able to recognize when something wrong with you, when you can't remember, you always losing things. You can't remember what you put your keys. You can't remember where you put your money at. You're always losing. You need deliverance. You got a lot of things going on in your mind, and you need to say, God, I need you to help me. See, this is where it's going to always go back to Holy Spirit, because he lives inside of you. It's where you got to learn to begin to form a relationship, a connection with him, that you begin to pay attention to what you do. You always talking negative. You need deliverance. Because guess what? Everything negative shouldn't be coming out of your mouth. Every time somebody say, I'm going through, child, everybody going through. It's going to always be like this. It ain't going to get no better. It's going to always, no. That's an indication you need deliverance. We got to be honest with ourselves, people of God. When we need help, we got to be willing to fight for it. A lot of times we're so used to demonic spirits living on the inside of us that you don't want to fight to get help. It's comfortable. If you're comfortable just doing nothing, that's an indication you need deliverance. Everybody else working on to improve themselves, but you're not doing anything, you need deliverance. Because we're supposed to be working. We're supposed to be working to make ourselves better, especially when you can help somebody else, but you won't help yourself. You need deliverance. You need the Holy Spirit to come in and to show you areas in your life where you're operating in darkness. Ask him, Holy Spirit, as I close out, Holy Spirit, show me, what have I been doing where I've been sabotaging myself? What am I doing while I can't read? What am I doing where I'm not putting forth the effort to change my life? I need you to deal with me and begin to be quiet and listen to him. Speak those, reveal those things to you in your mind. We got to get to a place where you're listening to Holy Spirit. Cut off the social media. Cut off the TV. Cut off the radio. And listen to your spirit man. You'll begin to hear the voices that are in your mind. You'll hear all different kind of people. Your mind will get to wondering. That's an indication you need deliverance. You need to get in the presence of God and say, I need you to wash me. I need you to cleanse me. Create in me a clean hands and a pure heart. Renew in me the rightful spirit. Because God, I have gotten out of your will. God, I need you to bring me back to where I need to be. Amen. I know that this is not something that will make us feel good, but guess what? It may not make you feel good, but it's going to help you. It's going to help you strengthen your life, and it's going to help you begin to see things the way that God sees them. But if you don't ever get into a place on working on being delivered, guess what? You're going to find your life spiraling down in a bad direction. Because guess what? Our life are not supposed to spiral down. We're supposed to be going forward. And you can't go forward if you're bound. Because demonic spirits, that's why you feel what you feel. Well, I don't feel like getting up. I don't feel like reading. I don't feel like doing anything. Those are spirits within you that don't want you to do any better. That's why you can't go by your feelings. The Bible say in Romans, Romans 8, the flesh is not saved. So you got to understand what we feel. That part of us is not saved. It takes us getting in the Word of God so the Holy Spirit can begin to reveal to us what is he saying to us. So when you're reading that word and he say, be angry but sin not, he let you know you got some anger on the inside of you. He's letting you know it's some things in you that you got to let go. It's some things in you that you got to forgive. When he sit up there and tell you, you shouldn't say that. You shouldn't call them out of their name. When you don't get convicted anymore for hurting people, You need deliverance. Because I am my brother's keeper. If you your brother's keeper, you're not going to hurt them. You're not going to think ill thoughts against them. You will begin to treat them how you want to be treated. Amen. So as I close out of this week, Deliver Me Nugget, I will pick up with part two on next Tuesday. These were tips to recognize that you need deliverance. Go back over Luke, the 4th chapter, verse 18. Jesus said that he came to set at liberty those who are oppressed. And that's what deliverance is, where he comes to reveal to you areas in your life that are in bondage, areas in your life that you're in darkness, and he reveal it to you. Amen? So I pray that this message was a blessing to you, and I will see you all next week. Be blessed.